Good morning. Happy Sunday. Can you hear those birds? Those birds are going to join us for this Sunday morning. I'm actually sitting outside of my house by a plant that I want you to take a look at. That pink plant all over the top of me. There it is. Because we're going to talk about that after I do the reading. So the reading today is from the Gospel according to John. Thank you, birds. Thank you for helping. Jesus said to his disciples, "I am the true vine. I am my Father, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears no fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." So we're hearing the word abide a lot. We're hearing a lot of talk about vines and branches. Now this plant behind me is called a bougainvillea. It's actually spelled pretty strange. If you saw the word bougainvillea, it would look like bougainvilla is what it would look like. But bougainvillea, something that's so interesting about this is that this, when the flowers aren't there, just looks like a pretty weird branch, just like kind of gnarly branch. And my husband, Dickie, Neil and James's dad, he knows what to do with it. He really spends a lot of time and he cuts back certain branches and he lets other branches grow. And it turns into this beautiful flowering flower, this vine branches that flower. And I was thinking about the bougainvillea when I was reading this gospel, because part of what I think Jesus is saying is that when you tend to something, when you take care of something, when you put work into something, it can really flower and become a beautiful thing. Even if it looks like something that wouldn't normally be beautiful, even if it looks like a branch, if you can do the right things, you can make it turn into something beautiful. And I think the other part of the message of this gospel is the idea that when we do things together, it's better, that we're better together. And I think that's true. If you think about when you have, I don't know if you have a brother or a sister. If you do, that's great. If you don't, that's great. But if you have a brother or sister or a friend and it's time to clean up at the end of the day, what's better? Cleaning up by yourself or cleaning up together? And I think the answer is always cleaning up together, because it seems like it gets done faster when everybody's working at it. And also it's more fun to do things with people, right? It's more fun, especially a chore like that. It's better to do things together. And I think that was sort of what Jesus is talking about too, that relying on each other, taking care of each other, working together. I'm there for you, you're there for me. And I think that's such a nice message. I think that's something we can really think about in our own lives is, okay, how can I help the people around me who are gonna help me back? And maybe what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a huge, beautiful flowering plant. And maybe what we're just gonna create is a huge, beautiful flowering friendship. And I think that is, when I read that story today from Jesus, that John told us about, that's what I think about. I think about how things that we put a lot of time and effort and care into, they can blossom and become something beautiful, and that we can also make things blossom and be beautiful when we work together, when we're with other people, when we trust in people, and when people take care of us and we take care of them back. So I hope you have a wonderful rest of your week. Next week is Mother's Day. So maybe there's something you can think about if you live with a mom, maybe there's something you can think about, or a grandma, or any sort of woman in your life that feels like a caretaker in any way, that's a mother figure. You can think about what you can do this week to prune their branches, to help their flowers grow. And I don't mean in their actual gardens, but maybe that is what it is. But what can you do to show that person how you care for them and how you want to help them create beauty? And I hope you have a great, great week and a happy rest of your Sunday. Enjoy this beautiful weather. Bye-bye.